Everybody, this is Jason from Electric Bike Technologies. This video is to deal specifically with folks that may be having a problem with their pedal assist sensor, or they think they are. The first thing about a pedal assist sensor is it's got to be installed correctly, it's got to be installed perpendicular, and we have another video that'll be right next to this one that shows you how to do that, and you would have to be seeing the red light blink to know that everything is good and that it's actually picking up the signal. The second part of pedal assist problems and potentially is the programming on the LCD. A lot of times we'll have people who didn't program their LCD at all and they think they have pedal assist problems. So I want to get into the LCD, I want to get right to the pedal assist settings, and these are what I want you to check. On this page or nearby, we have another video that walks through every setting on the LCD, so you can watch that as well if you're still having issues. But this one is specific to pedal assist not seeming like it's functioning even though you have a red blinking light. Let's get into the settings. I'm going to show you how to check it out. And what we're going to do is take them all back to the defaults, okay? So we have our LCD here. This is our Nokee model from 2017 through 2020. We're going to turn it on by pressing that M right there. Quick press, it comes on. We can hold the up arrow to get a backlight if we need a little bit of illumination. You can see here this is a brand new LCD. We're going to get into the settings and we're going to go right to the pedal assist settings. So I'm going to hold down to get into the settings menu. I'm going to hold down the up and down arrow together, simultaneously together, a couple seconds, and that gets us into the settings menu. This is ST1 or setting one, and we're going to cycle through using this M button on the side, okay? So we're going to click M. We have ST2, M, ST3, M, ST4, ST5, quick presses on the M, ST6, ST7, ST8 is where we want to be, all right? So ST8, P1-03. This is our startup delay, and I want you to put this to 5 for default. And then get to the next setting. We're going to click M, quick press. We're going to get to P2, and it says -5, which is the default. I want that on 5. We're going to click M again, and we get to P325. Here's where I want you to make a change. I want you to take this down to 7. No matter what you had it on, I want you to take it to 7. And then you're going to click M again. When you click M again, it's going to take you to the next setting, ST9. So the pedal assist has been set up right back to the defaults, okay? So those defaults are going to be P1 is going to be 5, the second setting is going to be 5, and the third is going to be 7, just like I showed you. Now at this point, we're going to turn it off. We're going to hold the M button down for a couple seconds, and that's going to get back to the main screen. We're going to hold it down again for a couple of seconds to save our settings by cycling off. And then we can press it again, quick press, and it'll come back on. At this point, I want you to go try again with your pedal assist, see if it's being responsive now that you've set the defaults. This is one of the troubleshooting steps we have if you call us and tell us that your pedal assist sensor is not working. So first you ensure there's a red light going, then you come back and you do this, try it out. Now, after you've done that, if you want to play around with the settings and try to make it more responsive based on what you have in the book, if you want to play around with those ST8 settings for pedal assist, you can go ahead into your book, you can read that, and you can try some things. But right now, to make sure pedal assist is working, this is what I want you to do.